Start with sets and subsets. A set is any well-defined collection of objects called the elements or the members of the set. A set is any well-defined collection of objects called the members or the elements of the set. So, now, for example, there is a collection of all wooden chairs, collection of all one-legged blackbirds, or collection of real numbers between 0 and 1. Each one is a set. Or a set of real numbers between 0 and 1. Set of real numbers between 0 and 1. One way of describing a set that has a finite number of elements is by listing the elements of the set. Between the listing of the elements of the set between the braces. One way of describing a set that has a finite number of elements is by listing the elements of the set between braces. For example, set of all positive integers that are less than 1 can be written as set 1, 2, 3. One way of describing a set is to express them in the curly braces. For example, a set of all numbers less than 3, a set of all numbers less than 3. For example, 1, 2. A set of all numbers less than 4, for example, will be the set 1, 2, 3, and so on. Now, the order in which the elements of the set are listed is not important. So, therefore, the set 1, 2, 3 can be written as 1, 3, 2, 3, 2, 1, 3, 1, 2, 2, 1, 3, and 2, 3, 1 are all the representations of the set given in 1, 1. The order in which the elements of the set are listed is not important. Thus, the element 1, 2, 3 can be written as 2, 1, 3, 3, 1, 2, 3, 2, 1, and so on. So, all the representations of the set given in 1 can be written as 1, 3, 2, 3, 2, 1, 3, 1, 2, 2, 1, 3, and 2, 3, 1. Now let us consider some of the examples based on the set theory. Next, example 1. Let capital A be equal to 1, 2, 3. Let capital A be equal to 1, 3, 5, 7. Then 1 belongs to A, 3 belongs to A, and 2 does not belong to A. This is example 1. Example 2. The set consisting of all the letters in the word byte can be denoted by curly brace B, Y, T, E, end of curly brace, or by curly brace X. X is a letter in the word byte. So example 2, the set consisting of all the letters, in the word byte can be written as B, Y, T, E. Or it is denoted by X is an element of the set such that X is a letter in the word byte. End of curly brace. This is one example. We shall see another example. Example 3. Z plus equal to x such that x is a positive integer. Thus z plus consists of the number used for counting 1, 2, 3 and so on. Z plus is equal to x such that x is a positive integer. Thus, z plus consists of the numbers used for counting 1, 2, 3. Thus, z plus consists of numbers used for counting 1, 2, 3 and so on. Another example. Let us say N. N is equal to X such that X is a positive integer or zero. n is equal to x, such that x is a positive integer or zero. So n consists of all the positive integers and zero. Which is written as 0, 1, 2 and so on. Then we take another example. We take z is equal to x, such that x is an integer. Thus, z consists of all the integer numbers -3, -2, -1, 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. Okay. So, z is equal to x, such that x is an integer. Thus, z consists of all the integers. Like -3, -2, -1. 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. Next, another example. R is a set of real numbers. R is equal to x, such that x is a set of real numbers. Now we define the empty set. If there are no elements in a set, or if the set has no elements, it is denoted by either blank curly braces or by the symbol phi, and it is called the empty set. Empty set. The set that has no elements, the set that has no elements is denoted by curly braces without having any elements, or by the symbol phi, and it is called the empty set. Next, now we take an example of equal sets. So equal sets. Directly we shall see the example. If capital A is equal to 1, 2, 3, and B is equal to x such that x is a positive integer and x square is less than 12. B is equal to x such that x is a positive integer and x square is less than equal to 12. In this case we say A is equal to B. So the two sets are equal. Because here 1 square is equal to 1, 2 square is equal to 4, 3 square is equal to 9. So all these elements, 1 is less than 12, 4 is less than 12, 9 is less than 12. So we say that x is a positive integer and x square is less than 12. So in this case, set A is equal to set B. We shall take another example. Example, if A is equal to, within curly braces we write basic, Pascal, ADA. If capital A is equal to basic, Pascal, ADA, and B is equal to let us say ADA, basic and Pascal, then A is equal to B. Set A is equal to set B, and we say that the two sets are equal sets. So this is the example of equal sets. Next, we shall study about subsets. If every element of A is also the element of B, then that is, if whenever X belongs to A and then X belongs to B, we say that A is a subset of B, or that A is contained in B, and we write it in this form: A is a subset of B. This is denoted by A is a subset of B. So, if every element of A is also an element of B, then that is, whenever X belongs to A then X belongs to B, we say that A is a subset of B. Or that A is contained in B. Then we can write it as A is a subset of B. Now, if A is not a subset of B, then we write it as this. It is denoted by this symbol. If A is not a subset, of B, we write A is not a subset of B. Now, this is denoted by diagrams which are called Venn's diagram. This is denoted by diagrams called Venn's diagrams. So let us study about Venn's diagram now. So suppose there is a set A and there is a set B, then we can write this as A is a subset of B. Now suppose if there are only a few elements which are common in A and B, in this case, we say that A is not a subset of B. Now, I label this as figure 1.1. The diagrams which are shown in figure 1.1, they are used to show the relationships between sets and they are called Venn's diagrams after the British logician John Venn. Next. Okay.